nationally, and you just really want to, you know, you'd like to see a guy at least play his junior year before you offer him. But we've offered kids off of sophomore tape and camp evaluations, and you worry about that. But there are always going to be guys. As a high school coach and educator, you know that were, good players as juniors, and all of a sudden, from the time that junior season ends to the time that senior season ends, really develop and evolve. Sean Beyer, okay? Perfect example right there. So, that, there's guys like that, and you just hope you can keep recruiting those kinds of guys.
Josie Jewell, one of those examples, too?
Josie Jewell was definitely one of those. He was a guy that, you look at his tape and he compared it with other guys, and Josie never came off the field. When we look at tapes, we're looking at guys that play one way in big schools where they have year-round football, and, they're training those kids year-round. I mean, Josie, heck, when football's over with, he's out on a basketball court. He's not playing football anymore. When basketball's over with, he's doing track. Then every night he's home farming or hunting or fishing. This guy, you love being around.
A lot has been written and said about your ability to find those hidden gems. Do you think it goes back to your high school days coaching those young men?
Well, I don't know about that, but when you're teaching, or coaching, you're always evaluating kids. You're out on the playground watching kids, or in a phys ed class, or you're in a gym watching your kids or watching other kids compete. That's what you do for fun, and you get to see kids and you say, boy, I really like that, and you see guys at a younger age and you kind of identify characteristics that you're looking for, and then you find out a little bit more about guys, there's great growth that can happen. Sometimes you have the kids that, as young players, play a lot but don't grow and develop. And then there's these kids that were a little awkward as junior high kids and maybe not that big. They grow and so forth. So, you see it all the time. You just have to try to, find guys that really kind of got the characteristics and traits you're looking for, I think.
Fifth year working with the defensive line. I just visited with Kelvin Bell a little while ago. He's excited about working with you.
Kelvin's Coach Bell. First of all, Kelvin playing here, he's been, he's done a great job with our recruiting right now, and I'm really excited to have Kelvin there because Kelvin's takes great pride in teaching guys. He's had a chance to coach at a number of different schools, and to come back here and to work with him, it's really good because, it's fun. We're kind of working together, and I really, really am excited to work with Kelvin. It was fun to work with him this spring, and it's going to continue to be that way.
And my final question, talk a little bit about the state of the defensive line for our listeners.
Well, I think inside at the tackle positions, we have experience. Jaleel, Nate, and Faith have played a lot, with Jaleel and Nate playing more. I think those two guys are solid. They certainly are not there yet. They've got work to do, and they'd be the first to admit that. Faith Akakadi really, really came on in the course of the year. The last three football games, Faith played extremely well. So we've got those three guys. Jake Hewlett's playing a little bit, in the two deep. And we've got some other guys that are kind of experiment there. So in the interior, we have experience. On the exterior, we lost two good seniors. We've got a couple of sophomores that are coming in doing a good job. Parker gained a lot of valuable experience. He's put on about 10 pounds of muscle. So he's, we're feeling good about him. Matt Nelson played last year, got on the field. Really a detailed guy. I think he's a guy that can contribute and really do a great job. Had a great spring. I think he's going to continue in that path of growth. And, I think the sky's the limit with him. Anthony Nelson, a redshirt freshman. Great ability, I think he's got great length athleticism. And then we've got Sam Brinks, who is from Carroll, Iowa, who's really done a good job. So you've got those four guys on the outside and those other four inside. So, we're a work in progress. We're a little bit young on the outside. We're a little bit more experienced on the inside. But, our goal is to continue to improve. That's all we want to do.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
How concerned are you with that pass rush? Because it would seem like you have a lot of youth there and experience.
Well, I think what you have, that's what we have. We have to continue to work. We have different sub packages that we've utilized at times to try to get more speed on the field. And I think we lost really two good pass rushers, on the edge last year. Drew was a guy, but Drew as a young player was very similar to where our guys are right now. Wasn't quite as developed and but he really came around. So, yeah, we've got to continue to work on it. We have to work on our technique. We have to work on, you know, our schemes, and we just have to work on developing our players. And that's the fun part.
And defensive tackle, one of the guys you didn't mention is Michael Slater. Yeah. Is the injury kind of slowed his development?
Yeah, Michael just had surgery here, and you know, so he's had an injury, and so he hasn't had the opportunity, so he's not quite there.
Coach, how much of an advantage of it, just being in the Big Ten championship game in the Rose Bowl, how big of an advantage is that for your guys to have that experience behind them?
No question it's a valuable experience because they played there. They know it's attainable, okay? They know what it took to get there. Now, getting there is hard. Staying there is a lot harder. There's going to be a lot of teams that are going to be, you know, are not taking us for granted by any means. And a lot of teams that are saying, hey, you know, we can hardly wait to have a chance to play Iowa.
Kirk said in Chicago that when you retire, he's going to have to replace you with three guys. Yeah. what do you have to say to that?
Three guys, yeah, right. I can't imagine that. I think he'll be happy when I retire, get me out of the building and so forth. No, but Coach has been very kind, and I really appreciate the opportunity to be here and work for such a good man. And you guys that cover him, you know the kind of person he is. Our players love him, trust him, care about him. So it's feel very fortunate to be here, and I mean, you're living the dream every day.